Part 21, the reinforcing and reduction methods of acupuncture. The reinforcing and reduction needling methods are divided into the classical school and the modern school. Generally speaking, those of the classical school are based on the theory of Jing Luo, such as setting the mountain on fire, penetrating heaven's fullness, yin within yang, yang within yin, and so on. These methods are very effective in reinforcing the deficient while dispersing the excessive. The various reinforcing and reduction methods of the old school are simplified into two basic methods, namely the gentle and the heavy needling methods. It is believed that the gentle needling method can cause excitement, while the heavy needling method can lead to inhibition. The modern methods are based on the nervous reflex theory. In spite of the difference in the theoretical foundation from that of the classical school, in practice, the modern methods are very effective. The two schools are quite similar in terms of kneeling location, technique, and therapeutic purpose. Now let's take a brief comparison of the two schools. The theoretical basis of the classical method is to regulate qi and blood through the jing luo, whereas the modern school is based on the nerve reflex. In the classical method, the concept of pathogenesis is based on the body's ability to resist disease versus that of the pathogens to induce disease. The modern school views disease as caused by weakened physiological functions, as well as hyperactive pathological changes. One can see that the basic concept of both these schools are quite similar. The classical therapeutic purpose aims at reinforcing the deficiency and reducing the excess. The modern one aims at improving the weakened physiological function and reducing the hyperactivity of the pathogens. The point locations are the same in both classical and modern methods, but the needling techniques are different from each other. The classical school employs the methods of reinforcing the deficient and reducing the excessive. The modern school employs the gentle needling method to excite the body and the heavy needling method to cause inhibition.
Cheng Dan'an said in Zhongguo Shengjiu Xue that reinforcing the deficient means exciting the tissue, which is in a state of hypofunction, and reducing the excessive implies inhibiting the tissue, which is in a state of hyperaction. He also writes that the gentle needling method functions to excite the tissue, and the heavily needling method causes inhibition. Nevertheless, differences exist between the classical and modern needling techniques. Classical methods are too complex and cannot be adopted completely. Yet, the simplicity of the modern method affects obtaining the optimum results. To solve this problem, Professor Yang Cheng, son of Nanjing Traditional Chinese Medical University, has expounded numerous simple methods from the classical school as a result of many years of study and analysis through scientific research, teaching, and clinical experience. He has set a standard of quality in order to distinguish between gentle and heavily kneading methods. Basic reinforcing and reduction methods.
一,
slow and rapid insertion and withdrawal.
徐集法,
with this method, reinforcing and reduction effects are achieved by varying the speed of insertion and withdrawal. Reinforcement is achieved through slow insertion and rapid withdrawal. After penetrating the skin, thrust the needle to the required depth through all three levels, with needling and manipulation at each level. Then, lift the needle to just below the skin before taking it out. Reducing is achieved through the opposite method, i.e., rapid insertion with slow withdrawal. After inserting the needle under the skin, thrust the needle directly to the required depth, and then manipulate the needle to promote the arrival of qi.
然后,
before taking the needle out, dip the needle three times to the three different levels, with manipulation at each level.
最后, 将针退至皮下, 出针, 这是卸法。 请再看一遍。
When reinforcing,
这是补法颈针。在补法中，颈针过程慢是为了逐渐增加刺激量，退针过程快是为了限制刺激量，以防止刺激量过重而破坏补法的作用。
When reducing, rapid thrusting is used to increase stimulation, and slow lifting will further increase the degree of stimulation in order to reduce the excess.
这是卸发颈针。在卸发中，进针过程快是为了骤增刺激量，退针过程慢是为了放足刺激量，以避免刺激量太轻而不达卸发的目的。请看图表。补法的进针方式为慢进快退，刺激量轻。卸法的进针方式为快进慢退，刺激量重。二，捻转法。
Rotation。
捻转法是以大拇指和食指捻转针柄的一种行针方法。行针时，针体在书穴内左右运动而产生刺激，利用角度、频率和单位之差，可以区别刺激量的轻重。行针时，左右一个来回为一次。捻转角度小、频率慢、单位少、刺激量轻为补法。
The angle is less than 180 degrees, and the frequency of manipulation is up to 5 times per 10 seconds.
捻转角度大，频率快，单位多，刺激量重为卸法。
And strong stimulation. The angle is larger than 180 degrees, and the frequency should be 10 times per 10 seconds.
请看图表。捻转法的单位包括角度与频率。补法行针时，角度小于180度，每10秒钟行针5次，刺激量轻。卸法行针时，角度大于180度，每10秒钟行针10次，刺激量重。三，提叉法。
Lifting and thrusting.
提叉法是以大拇指、食指、中指捏紧针柄，使针体做向上向下运动的一种行针方法。向上为提，向下为叉，一提一叉为一次。
Here, reinforcing is achieved by shallow thrusting, slow frequency, and mild stimulation.
提叉幅度浅，频率慢，单位少，刺激量轻为补法。
And strong stimulation.
提叉幅度大，频率快，单位多，刺激量重为卸法。
The depth, frequency,and the difference in the unit.
针体在书穴内上下运动而产生的刺激量，可利用深度、频率和单位之差进行区别。
less than 10 millimeters, and lifting and thrusting the needle 5 times every 10 seconds.
请看图表。提叉法的单位包括深度和频率。补法针刺深度小于10毫米。每10秒钟提叉5次，刺激量轻。卸法针刺深度大于10毫米，每10秒钟提叉10次，刺激量重。
And lifting and thrusting the needle 10 times every 10 seconds with strong stimulation. Number four,
四留针法。留针法是将针留置于输穴中数分钟至数小时或数日的一种针法，用于加强补泻作用、后气。现在的皮内针和嵌针的埋藏法概由留针演变而来。
This method is subdivided into two subcategories.
留针法又分为动留针法和静留针法两种。
Without manipulation.
动留针法即在留针过程中每隔五至十分钟用捻转、劈叉等法反复施术，四至五分其数，刺激量较重为泻法。静留针法即在留针过程中不加捻转、劈叉等法，静以久留，刺激量较轻为补法。请看图表。补法留针方式为静留针、不行针、刺激量轻；泻法留针方式为动留针、行针、刺激量重。
Number five,
五
respiration.
呼吸法。呼吸法即施术时利用患者或医生的呼吸，利用自然呼吸或使然呼吸进行行针的方法，令患者做使然呼吸时进针、出针有避痛作用。医生用自然呼吸行针可以保证节律匀称，既以提高计算刺激量的精确度。进针、出针，利用患者的使然呼吸，呼气进针。
Insertion of the needle with exhalation and withdrawal of the needle with inhalation is known as reinforcing method.
吸气出针，这是补法。
Insertion of the needle with inhalation and withdrawal with exhalation is considered as reducing.
呼气出针，
The patient's respiration is coordinated with insertion and withdrawal.
请看图表。患者使然呼吸进出针法。补法，患者呼气时进针，吸气时出针。泻法，患者吸气时进针，呼气时出针。捻转劈叉，利用医生的自然呼吸，借以计算频率的快慢。一呼一吸为一吸，一吸四次为慢，刺激量轻，宜用于补法。一吸八次为快，刺激量重，宜用于泻法。请看图表。医生自然呼吸行针法。补法， 行针频率为一息四次，刺激量轻。泻法，行针频率为一息八次，刺激量重。
Number six.
六
Keeping the hole open or closed.
开合法是出针后对针孔的一种处理方法。补法配合轻刺激，如文盲指，出针后按闭针孔，防止血气外溢，保护正气。切割时局部反应消失。
Pressing the hole can reduce any local reaction.
泻法配合重刺激，摇大气道，出针后不闭针孔，出些血气，疏散邪气，切割使局部反应延长。
Particularly pathogenic qi, and can prolong the local reaction.
请看图表。补法，出针后按闭针孔，防止出血，使精气得存。泻法，出针后不按闭针孔，不防出血，已出七级。七
Number seven,
九六法
Nine and six manipulation.
九六法是利用捻转劈叉的单位量进行行针的方法。古代以九数数阳为补，六数数阴为泻。凡捻转或劈叉，以九次为一个单位是补法，以六次为一个单位是泻法。 这是捻转补法行针，以九次为一个单位。
By rotating, lifting, and thrusting the needle for nine times, which is considered one unit.
这是提叉补法行针，以九次为一个单位。
By rotating, lifting, and thrusting the needle for six times, which is considered one unit.
这是捻转泻法行针，以六次为一个单位。这是提叉泻法行针，也以六次为一个单位。
Shaking.
摇摆法是在行针或出针时将针柄左右摇摆的一种手法，旨在加强刺激。
The needle is shaken from side to side without rotation, lifting or thrusting.
行针时旨在行气，不捻转，不劈叉，左右摇摆幅度小，频率慢，刺激量轻为补法。
A large amplitude.And fast frequency with strong stimulation is reducing.
行针时不捻转不提叉，左右摇摆幅度大，频率快，刺激量重为泻法。退针时将针柄左右摇摆，使针孔摇大，退至天部， 待针下松动，将针拔出为泻法。请看图表。补法，摇摆幅度小，频率慢，刺激量轻。泻法，摇摆幅度大，频率快，刺激量重。
Number nine,
九
circling
盘旋法。盘旋法即将针自主书写后，手捏针柄，使针尾向四周倾斜，做360度盘旋，如画圆圈，左右来回，不加捻转提插。此法适用于腹部脂肪厚、捻转提插不易得气的患者，可以加强刺激。盘旋幅度小，频率慢，刺激量轻为补法。
Reinforcing is applied by a small amplitude of circling and a slow frequency with mild stimulation.
盘旋幅度大，频率快，刺激量重为泻法。
Reducing is employed by a large amplitude and a rapid frequency with strong stimulation.
请看图表。补法，盘旋幅度小，频率慢，刺激量轻。泻法，盘旋幅度大，频率快，刺激量重。
Number ten.
十，迎随法。迎随法是以经脉流注方向为依据的刺针方法，顺经脉而刺，有增强经气运行的作用；逆经脉而刺，有减弱经气的作用。如手太阴肺经，起于中焦，由胸走手出拇指的桡侧端。刺针时，针芒顺着经脉流注方向斜刺为补法。刺针时，针芒逆着经脉流注方向斜刺为泻法。腹式补泻手法。
The comprehensive reinforcing and reducing methods.
前面向大家介绍了单式补泻手法，在应用中，将单式补泻手法有机的组合，就构成了腹式补泻手法。一、烧山火法。本法有徐集进针法、九六法、呼吸进针法组合而成，主治肢冷脉浮、瘫痪、肌肤不仁、寒虚、阳虚等病症。请看操作。呼气进针，手法为三进一退，紧插慢提。进针后，将针刺至天部，行针。
Upon withdrawal,
再将针刺至人部，行针。
And press the hole closed after the needle is withdrawn.
最后将针刺至地部，行针。出针时按闭针孔。二，透 透天凉法。
Number two, penetrating heaven's coolness.
本法也由习集进真法、九六法、呼吸进真法组合而成，主治风痰壅盛、中风、癫狂等一切阳气有余之症。
Phlegm syndrome,
请看操作。
Wind stroke, epilepsy, mental disorders.
吸气进针。
Manipulations.
进针后，将针刺至臂部行针。
Manipulate the needle at the three levels of depth.
再将针提至人部行针。最后将针提至天部行针。
Skin, with the hole kept open for a while.
出针后不必针孔。三，阳中隐阴法。
Yin hidden within yang.
本法由习集进针法、九六法演变而来。请看操作。
Achieved by slow and rapid insertion and withdrawal, as well as the nine and six manipulations.
将针刺至天部，按阳数行针。
Excess within deficiency syndrome. Manipulations. Divide the needling depth into two parts.
然后将针刺至地部，按阴数行针。
And manipulate the needle according to the yang number.
先寒后热，一切虚中加实之症。
The deep level.And rotate the needle according to the yin number. Number four.
四
yang within yin.
阴中引阳法。本法也由徐集进针法、九六法演变而来。请看操作。
Slow and rapid insertion and withdrawal, and the nine and six manipulations. Manipulations.
进针后，先将针刺至地部，按阴数行针，然后将针退至天部，按阳数行针。
Rotate six times, and then lift to the shallow and rotate nine times.
本法主治先热后寒，一切实中加虚之症。
Deficiency mixed with excess syndrome.
以上四法是分层补泻，适用于肌肉较厚的穴位，如肩
俞、
环跳等。
举持、烧山火、
烧山火、
透天
凉进针深度，分天、人、地三层。阳中引阴、阴中引阳进针深度分天、地两层。
Are divided into the two parts of shallow and deep.
五，青龙摆尾法。
Number five, blue dragon swings tail.
本法在进针得气后，将针尖朝向病所，捏住针柄，一左一右慢慢摆动九次或二十七次。本法主治。经络壅滞、闭闭不通诸症，本法适用于不宜垂直进针的穴位，用斜刺或延皮刺法。行针时，手执针柄慢慢摆动，刺激量轻为补法。
When reinforcing, hold the handle of the needle and shake it gently.
若增加摆动幅度和频率，也可用于实证。
Increase the amplitude and frequency while shaking the needle.
六
Number six,
白虎摇头法。
White tiger shakes head.
本法将提叉、捻转、摇摆三法同时并用。并注重利用医生的自然呼吸来控制行针的频率，重复次数多为泻，重复次数少为补。请看操作。 将针刺至预定深度，医生根据自己的呼吸插针时左转，一呼一摇，提针时右转，一吸一摇。本法主治经络壅滞，臂臂完麻诸症。
七，
仓龟探穴法。本法适用于局限性臂痛胀麻等症，由痛处中点进针，然后调转针芒向上下左右各刺一针。透针时分三次而进。
Pain and numbness of the local area.
退针时一次退至终点，刺臂四方。
Number
eight, Red Phoenix
flying in and out. 8. Manipulations. Divide the depth of the point into three levels.
本法在进针后
middle, and deep.
先将针刺至底部。
Insert the needle to the deep level, and then lift to the shallow.
再提至天部。
After the arrival of qi, thrust the needle.Into the middle level. Hold the needle handle and move around the point 360 degrees. Then twirl the needle and release the hole, causing a vibration that strengthens the needling sensation.
一捏一放，使针柄摇晃产生震动，以加强针感。本法主治痛臂、胃痹。瘫痪、肌挛等症。
Paralysis and so on.
九。
Number nine.
龙虎交战法。
The fight between the dragon and the tiger.
本法由九六法演变而来，以左右捻转分阴阳。
Manipulation.
请看操作。
Insert the needle to the required depth. Rotate the needle counterclockwise.
将针刺至一定深度后，左转九阳指数。
Then clockwise 6 times.
右转六阴指数，反复行事。
Repeat this procedure several times.
本法适用于不宜提插的输血、主治一切臂尾痛症。
With lifting and thrusting methods, such as 列缺、内停 and 大铃。Indications: atrophy and B syndrome. 10.
十
Dragon and tiger ascending and descending.
本法在天、人、地三步提插，又加盘法数泻。进针后，先将针插至天部，左盘一转，将针插至人部，再慢慢提至天部，右盘一转。
Lift the needle to the shallow level again, and turn clockwise 9 times.
按此方式体插，反复九次。
Thrust the needle downward to the deep level, and turn the needle clockwise.
然后，将针插至地部，右盘一转，提至天部。再慢插至地部，
Finally,
左盘一转。
Lift the needle to the shallow level, and then thrust to the deep. Again, turning the needle counterclockwise for six times.
本法主治。
Indication,
一切气血壅滞之症。
All obstruction syndromes of qi and blood.
11.
Number 11.
子午倒灸法。
Vigorous lifting and thrusting.
本法提插幅度大，并结合捻转，刺激量特大，属重卸法。请看操作。
Manipulations. Insert the needle into the skin.
待针下得气后，施行体插，每次三进两出，反复三次，并在进针时按老阳数结合捻转，出针时按老阴数结合捻转。
Gentle thrusting and six clockwise rotations. Repeat this procedure several times.
本法主治
Indications,
水谷膈气
ascites and edema.
12.
Number 12.
恶马摇铃法
Hungry horse shaking bell.
本法行针，但用缓缓进退。
This is a gentle lifting and thrusting needling method for those patients who have poor tolerance and delicate constitution.
可能从灵枢中徐入徐出的道气法演变而来，最适合于体质虚弱、耐受性差的病人。请看操作。
Manipulations.
用右手大拇指、食指粘住针头，如恶马摇铃指状，缓缓将针插至地部，然后再将针缓缓提至人部，反复操作。本法主治一切虚症，复式手法操作沿用古法，但在具体施术时。仍应按照轻补重卸的原则进行灵活运用。以上向大家介绍了单式和复式补卸手法。在临床上，我们可以针对具体病症和输血部位的不同，灵活的运用。
And reducing with heavy needling methods.
尽管补泻手法内容错综复杂，各有所宜，但其基本原理是一致的，即轻自能补，重自能泻。只要我们运用得当，就可以达到提高疗效的目的。
The physician can choose between.The described methods. Although the manipulations and indications of the methods appear to be complex and varied, the underlying principle remains the same. That is, the gentle needling is for reinforcement, and heavy needling is for reduction. Proper application of the methods leads to proper prognosis.